Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 83 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 144 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 145 and question 146. Question 145. You create an Azure storage account named Contoso Storage. You plan to create file share named Data. Users need to map drive to data file share from home computers that run Windows 10. Which outbound port should you open between home computers and data file share? Option A, port 80. Port 80 is used with HTTP traffic or HTTP web traffic. Therefore, this would not be the correct answer. Option B, port 443. Port 443 is used with HTTPS traffic. Therefore, option B is not the correct answer. Option D, 3389 port, that is used with remote desktop connections or RDP. Therefore, this would not be the correct answer. Therefore, we are left with option C, port 445. Let's verify this on the documentation site. We are in learn.microsoft.com and on troubleshoot Azure files page. If we scroll down, the following table provides SMB, NFS and file rest requirements for which of the network endpoints of a storage account they can use and which port that endpoints can be accessed over. Therefore, port 445 option C is the correct answer. Question 146. You have an Azure storage account named storage 1 that contains a blob container named container 1. You need to prevent new content added to container 1 from being modified for 1 year. What should you configure? Option A, the access tier. The access tier is used with Azure Storage to store blob data in cost-effective manner. Access tier is incorrect answer. Option C, access control or identity and access management settings. These are being used to provide secure and controlled access to resources for the users. Therefore, it is not being used to manage the access of the content. Option D, access level. Access level is being used in DevOps and not applicable for this purpose or content access management. Therefore, we are left with option B, an access policy. To understand it better, let's go to Azure portal and see how access policy can manage the content based on time. We are in Azure portal now. We'll go to our resource group. Under the resource group, we have storage account, AzureWala SA1. Under the storage account, we'll go to containers. And under the containers, we'll go to container 1. Under the container 1, we have access policy. And under the access policy, we do have immutable blob storage. We can add policy. Under the add policy, we can go to time-based retention. Under the time-based retention, we go to set retention period 4, and we can read here the enter the time interval in days that the data needs to be kept in a non-erasable and non-modifiable state. So here we will define 365 days and we can save this policy. Let's go back to question. Therefore, option B, an access policy, is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.